He was once described as the greatest man to never become Prime Minister. Bill Hayden, the former Whitlam government minister, Labor leader and Governor-General, has died aged 90. Tonight, he's being remembered for his achievements, including being a key architect of universal healthcare.
Bill Hayden was a true believer.
Every day is exciting. This is a particularly glorious day.
A Labor Party man to the core, preaching the cause of working Australians.
Well, the present scheme covers only about 83% of the public at best.
He was also a man who, after a lifetime as an atheist, underwent a complete change of heart in his spiritual beliefs, accepting Christianity, baptised in the Catholic Church at the age of 85.
Bill Hayden.
That was true Bill Hayden, who spent his life thinking, reflecting and evolving.
But I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II.
He was most renowned for being the man who almost became Prime Minister. Bill took over the party leadership from Gough Whitlam in 1977, and he brought Labor within striking distance of winning power, only to have the prize ripped from his grasp by Bob Hawke, who replaced him just weeks before Labor won the 1983 federal election. Bill Hayden delivered an iconic quip.
So I am not convinced that the Labor Party would not win under my leadership. I believe that a drover's dog could lead the Labor Party to victory.
Journalist Richard Carlton took a famous shot at Hawke.
Could I ask you whether you feel a little embarrassed tonight at the blood that's on your hands?
Now, Mr. Carlton, you can sit there with your silly, quizzical face. You've got a reputation right around this country. Yeah, it's looking better still.
He might have been robbed of the top job, but Hayden left a strong footprint in Australian politics. As Minister for Social Security under Whitlam, he introduced Medibank and the single mother's pension. He served as Treasurer and later Foreign Minister.
That if they supported it, then the United States was prepared to endorse it.
The former soldier, rugby player, rower and police officer had come a long way.
That if I did that, I would be guaranteeing great damage to my own party at the cost of my own personal interests. And I'm afraid my motivation goes beyond that.
Hawke would later make Bill Hayden Governor-General, a role he held for 7 years.
The Honourable Bill Hayden, Governor-General-Designate of the Commonwealth of Australia.
He didn't swear allegiance on a Bible, instead a simple affirmation of loyalty.
It was a life of service with a strong social conscience. He kept faith and he also found it. Damien Ryan, Nine News.
And the Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese, gave this tribute to Bill Hayden from Canberra a short time ago.
If Bill Hayden left no other legacy than as a key architect of universal healthcare, he would stand for all time as a legend of our Labor movement and a great contributor to our nation.